Hello and welcome to the course Physics and Chemistry of the Interstellar Medium. My name is Markus Röllig and I'm your lecturer for this course in the winter semester 2021 given at the Frankfurt Goethe University. I will start with a short organizational summary, and in this short summary, I will talk about all the technical aspects and the administrative aspects of the course. The name of the course is Physics and Chemistry of the Interstellar Medium. All the material related to the course is collected on the website. On the website of the course, you can also use here the QR link to connect to the website. The course itself will be given in English. The lecture notes are also entirely in English. If you succeed in this course, you will get 3 credit points, and you have also the option of having a graded certificate, so a benotete Schein. The regular lecture time is Tuesday starting at 12 o'clock CT, so we will start at 12:15. Given the current COVID-19 situation, this will not be an in-presence lectures, but will be given entirely online, and I will explain in a second how this works. You can also contact me, use the email that is also provided on the webpage, and I'm also available before or shortly after the lecture. The lecture itself is open to all physics students, preferably at master level or above, and it is expected that you have some basic astrophysical knowledge. For example, when you took the Astrophysik 1 lecture. As I already mentioned, this will be an online course, so we will have no in-presence sessions. I will pre-record the lecture as video and distribute it to you via YouTube. The video links will be collected on the course page. The lecture videos will be published 1 week before the scheduled lecture time. So always on Tuesdays, I will publish the video links for the lecture that takes place in the coming week. During the actual lecture time, we will not repeat the contents of the video and of the lecture notes, but we will have an Q&A session. So this is supposed to be an interactive session where you have the option of asking questions and I can give additional explanation, maybe provide in-depth examples, and we will try to have discussions on small questions and problems that I pose during these Q&A sessions. They will take place using Zoom, and they will also be recorded, and I will publish the recordings of these sessions. As I already mentioned, the time for this Zoom Q&A sessions is always Tuesdays, 12 o'clock. The Zoom login is provided on the webpage and also in the syllabus. There is, of course, also the option to shift the time for this online meeting if there's a conflict with other courses, because we now are not limited to room availability of the university. So if you have severe conflicts between courses at Tuesday 12 o'clock time, then please contact me and we will try to arrange for an option that as many of you can attend the course. I also set up a Discord channel related to discussions that are related here to the course, to create a virtual room where you can exchange and more also contact me if you need. So one of the big problems with the current online lecturing is that this limits your possibilities and your interactions with other students. So this is one offer from my side to have the possibility to reach out to other students. On this page, I briefly summarize the topics that we will cover during the semester. So we will talk about the dynamics of the interstellar gas. So this includes the hydrodynamic equations, magneto-hydrodynamic equations, turbulence, effects of magnetic fields, and so on. We will then move on to radiative transfer. So we will look at what are radiation properties of the interstellar gas, how does the interstellar gas interact with radiation in terms of absorption and of emission. Then we will move on from the interstellar gas to the interstellar dust, look what is known observationally, what are characteristics of the interstellar dust, how is it important for the overall physical and chemical conditions of the interstellar medium. We will then move on to looking at the overall energy balance of the ISM. And given sufficient time at the end of the semester, we will also look at special regions such as H2 regions, photon-dominated regions, and so on. This is a somewhat shorter semester compared to previous years. So it might be that I have to cut the contents a little bit. We will try to cover also some introductory chemistry of the interstellar medium. But this will mostly be a course on the physics of the interstellar medium. This is some of the literature that can be used in addition to the course material that I provide. There are a few textbooks available, for example, from Bruce Drain, Physics of the Interstellar and Intergalactic Medium, or by Thielens, The Physics and Chemistry of the Interstellar Medium. So here, these are very good books. There's also the option of looking for lecture notes that are available online. So here's a good series of lecture notes on the chemistry of the interstellar medium. And there are also some other materials available. Here I collect a couple of online resources that we might also need during the semester. So there's the very important abstract server, the ADS, Astrophysics Data System. This is basically a large database collecting all the published papers in astrophysics of all the relevant journals. Here you can find scientific papers and you can very often also download them or get a link to the journal page. And there's a preprint server here where you might have the option to access these papers without being behind a paywall. And here I collect a few databases of astronomical data. Yeah. And then there's the option to get a graded certificate. We will have no exercises or no problems that you have to hand in. So for me to have the possibility to grade your performance, You will have to present a short presentation in which you present the contents of an important paper, scientific paper, a historic paper maybe, or a more recent one, during one of these Q&A sessions. And your grade will be based upon these this presentation. So this is supposed to be short, in the order of 15 minutes, and you should use everything that you typically use when you do an online presentation, so PowerPoint and so on. Here it's very difficult to have a workload sharing, for example, two students or more students working on a common topic, because only one can give a presentation. So if this is something you want to do, you have to contact me and we have to figure out a topic maybe that can be reasonably split into separate parts that then every of you can present. Here's a small collection of possible papers that can be used to present in these journal club presentation thing. But I'm also open for suggestions from your side.